Good evening. Welcome to Bristol Community College. My name is Wendy Sanford, and I'm the program coordinator for the nursing assistant program here at BCC. I would like to welcome all of you to our pinning ceremony tonight. Thank you for all coming. The students have worked extremely hard to accomplish this and appreciate everyone who has come out to celebrate. I want to take the time to thank the family and friends who have supported the students throughout this program. The schedules were demanding, fast-paced, and they could not have succeeded without the support of so many family and friends. Thank you. This pinning ceremony, we are celebrating the Center for Workforce and Community Education is recognizing students that have completed the Nurse Aid Training, Home Health Aid Program, and PCA Program during the summer and fall semester. We have had a total of 100 students to be acknowledged for their accomplishments this evening. We feel blessed to have had the pleasure to assist in training such wonderful students. We are excited to continue training highly qualified, experienced healthcare employees. I would like to take a moment to introduce our BCC members that we have on stage with us this evening. We have our president, Jack Spraga. Our vice president of workforce development, Paul Vigent. Our dean of the Center for Workforce, Carmen Aguilar. Our director for the Center for Workforce, Nicolette Collard-Andrade. And our amazing instructors, Suzanne Parent, Judy Andrade, and Sue Sylvia. I would like to thank all of the people here that help make this program happen. We continue to grow as a program, and this couldn't be done with the support of all the people behind me. To all of the students, I know entering the first few days of class, some of you were unsure if this was for you, if you chose the right educational path, or if you were ready for the adventure, or could handle the demands of this program. Well, I'm here to tell you, you made the right decision. You made the right choice coming to BCC and choosing to be part of the healthcare field. You picked a very rewarding and self-gratifying field. You may not be rich, as many or most see it, but you will be rich in hugs, prayers, smiles, and the many thank yous you will receive throughout the days of your work. To see the difference you can personally make in one resident's life is amazing and is very rewarding. Some of you in the audience here tonight may not know what a CNA, home health aide, or a PCA does. At this time, I'd like to introduce one of our day CNA classes to come up and read a poem that perfectly states what a CNA is. It describes the profession perfectly. So I'd like to introduce Erin, Molly, Jillian, Kayla, Eliana, and Hannah to come up and speak.
Who are you to refer to us as only a CNA? We're the ones who wash and dress our patients for the day. We're the ones who take the time to listen to them speak. We listen about their lifetime in a 40-hour week.
We also give our hands to hold when someone's feeling scared. It's not easy being a patient. You're never quite prepared. We take the time to listen by lending both our ears. We listen to their worries or how they've spent their years.
Our arms were made to reach and even wrap around, to give our patients hugs when they are feeling a little down. We help our patients do the things they used to do on their own. Everyone needs some help, even when we're grown.
So who are you to refer to us as only CNAs? We do our best to meet their needs within our working day. We choose to do this job. The job did not choose us. We sympathize and empathize. Compassion is a must.
We try to keep them comfortable and free of any fear. We sit around beside them when that time is near. We hold their hands, stroke their hair, just making sure they know they're not alone, and it is there. It's okay for them to go.
To
To all the CNAs, keep your head held high. We're not only CNAs, we're angels in disguise.
Thank you. That poem perfectly describes what a CNA is, and all of them are angels in disguise and will have a huge impact on many people that they care for throughout the years. I'm sure every one of you celebrating tonight has at least one or two stories you can tell about your clinical rotation or caring for someone special, and you will have hundreds more as you go throughout your career. Some residents do not have visiting family or friends. You are now their family. You are now someone they can depend on seeing daily. They might be having a bad day, and you have brightened it. And they will remember that moment forever. The type of effect you have on those you care for. Caring and compassion is what you need to become a wonderful CNA. Never lose your compassion for caring. You all have the caring and compassion needed to make wonderful caregivers and continue your education in the healthcare field. At this time, I'd like to introduce our president, Dr. Jack Sprager.
Well, thank you and good evening. Welcome everyone to Bristol Community College. It's a great night when we celebrate our graduates, and this is a wonderful occasion for the college as well as for each of them. I want to congratulate, first I want to congratulate all our poets, and they do a great job. We're very happy about that. Thank you. So we have our nurse assistant training, our home health care, health aide, and personal care attendants. All on the roll to careers in very important health providing for our community. And what I'm here to do today is to not only congratulate each of the graduates, but to emphasize to them the importance of moving on and moving upward. They've done a lot of work to get to tonight, but there is much work yet to be done in terms of moving up the pathways and the career pathways that BCC has available to them. So I hope you'll consider moving ahead, keep going. You're probably tired of classwork and coursework already, but we have more for you, okay? And I highly recommend to you that you continue. BCC stands ready to support you in any way we can. But whether you go on or not, you always have a home here at BCC. You're part of our BCC family. So we wish you well, and Godspeed. Thank you.
Thank you, President Sprager. At this time, I'd like to introduce Caitlin Borg to speak.
So first, I'd like to say that this was a wonderful experience, and I'm so glad to have taken this course, even though I was super nervous at first. I feel like I had a really great group of women that I did the course with and fantastic teachers. We had a really small group, so I feel like we really got to bond, and nothing brings people real close like practicing bedpans on each other. I would like to thank everyone at BCC for making this program so great, and thank my parents and my boyfriend for supporting me through the whole thing. And I wish all the graduates the best of luck in their future careers. Thank you.
Thank you, Caitlin. Next, I'd like to introduce our Vice President of Workforce Development, Paul Vigent.
Thank you. This is always such a great graduation ceremony to come to. You know, we get invited to a lot, and then just some stand out. And for me, this particular graduation ceremony stands out in part because you've brought your crew here tonight, right? Everybody who helped each of you get to where you are today is there. So I want to remind the crowd, whooping it up and yelling when your graduate goes across the floor is really, I would really encourage you to do that, because as you know, these students put in a lot of effort to successfully complete this program, and like me, I'm sure you're very, very proud of them. And it starts, as Wendy said, with these three magnificent faculty members. Sue and Suzanne and Judy, thank you for what you do. And yeah, right, right. At BCC, the culture kind of starts with Jack and this notion that a college like BCC in a place like Fall River and New Bedford and Taunton and Attleboro can really change the world by changing lives, learner by learner. That's sort of the motto that we go from. And Jack, he starts the culture by really reminding us every day, right, to keep the main thing the main thing. And the main thing is student success. So we're really pleased and so proud when we can come here and recognize the hard work they've done. So I'm gonna address the remainder of my remarks as best I can, kind of going back and forth to the students, because what's so important about today, and you know it, but what's so important today is you've done something which is you've earned credentials, right? You have earned credentials now that are recognized in the healthcare sector, they're recognized in the college. They allow you, as Jack said, if you decide to continue your education, access to get credit, academic credit for what you've done. So it's a big deal to have an earned credential, because no matter whatever happens, no one can ever take that earned credential away from you. So congratulations, that's a lot of work. And you really represent the best of what BCC is, right? You have also this special skill, which I tell my staff, they always warn me, like, don't start crying during your talk tonight. But it's because these particular students have this special gift, and it's what Wendy was starting to say. They're caregivers, right? Think of what they do as a profession. They enrich the lives of people who are sick. They enrich the lives of people who are elderly. I know I'm like the worst patient in the world. When I go in, I'm freaking out. I'm always nervous. I'm so anxious. And it's the CNA and the when you get home, the home health aide and the personal care attendant that nurtures the patient. And that gift, that special gift of giving, is what differentiates you as individuals from everybody else in the world. So you've taken this really special gift and you've honed it, and you've developed it, and you've brought it to a level of professionalism that is so important in our society. So again, I congratulate you. I can't say how really moving it is to think of what you do and that special gift that you have. So congratulations. Round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for the graduates. And in closing, they've probably thanked you 100 times, but if they haven't yet, it's because they're so busy doing what they're doing to get to this place, they haven't really had the time to put it on pause to thank you. But on behalf of them, I want to thank everybody in the room, because you're the support network that got them through. So thank you, enjoy the night.
Thank you, Paul. Next, I'd like to invite Brianna Pyers up to speak.
When we first started, we were a group of 8 strangers, and we never imagined how close we would become in such a short amount of time. We grew not only as students, but as people, helping and teaching one another along the way. Although we worked hard, we had a lot of fun, making it easier to remember and perform our skills. At this moment, we want to give a special thank you to our instructors, Wendy, Sue, Judy, and Suzanne. You have all taught us so much and gave us the encouragement we needed along the way. Although it is time for us to go our separate ways, we feel confident going into our future endeavors. It has been a great few months that we will always remember.
Thank you, Brianna. Next, I'd like to introduce Jared Willett to speak.
All First, I'd like to thank my fiance, Megan, my parents, Paul, Pauline, for all their support, the instructors and my fellow classmates during classes and clinicals. It's through the instructor's dedication and hard work that me and my classmates are here tonight. Well, half the reason. The other half is because we were all meant for the medical profession in one way or another. We were born to help each other, and completing the CNA course is taking our first steps into that life. So just on behalf of everybody, I'd like to thank all of you for coming tonight, and congratulations to everybody.
Thank you, Jared. At this time, we're going to put on a short slideshow of some of the pictures and things that the students have done in their class experience. It's a lot of fun. We do a lot of learning, but we do have a lot of fun as well. They get very close and do things with each other that at the beginning of class they didn't think they would be doing. So it is a really good time to reflect on what the semester brought and how close they have become. So we'll just get 1 second for them to get that all set. If you want to just turn around, stay in your positions, but you can turn around. can see they do have a lot of fun in class. The songs that we chose for that was a reflection, that last song really a reflection of being a CNA, that they're gonna stand by their patients, they're gonna stand by their residents. CNA is one of those jobs, it's a really tough job, and they're gonna do an excellent job at it because they all have the caring and compassion that they need. As a CNA, you know that every day you're gonna touch, you will touch a life, or your life will be touched by someone. You'll be there for your residents, your patients at the hardest times in their lives. Your smile, compassion, and hard work will always be remembered by them, and you will always stand by your residents. At this time, I'd like to, before we go into our certificates, I'd like to thank our clinical placements. Currently, right now, our students had done their clinical rotation at Life Care Center of Raynham, Clifton Rehabilitation in Somerset, and Sarah Brayton in Fall River. So we thank those facilities for giving our students excellent clinical experiences to gain all the skills that they needed to complete the program. At this time, we're going to do the presentation of certificates and the pinning, which is what everybody has been waiting for. So at this time, I'd like to introduce, I'd like to ask our Dr. Sprager, Paul Vigent, Carmen, Nikki, well, are you making fun of me? And the instructors to come up for the pinning.
Okay, we rehearsed this a little bit, so we'll see how it works. If we could have student Sumaya Abdeljalil. Stanzia Bankert. Vanessa Barrows. Christina Bennett. Crystal Carallo. Erin Quanta. Molly Donnelly. Kimberly Furtado. Allison Gerard. Jillian Hamlin. It always gets bogged up on this side, always. Catherine Kiesling. Teresa Lindra. Tricia Mania. Kayla Martins. Alania Montalvo. Jared Willett. Amy Parkett. Brianna Pyers. Andrew Pollack. Stephanie Pont. Ryan Raposa. Armando Santos. Hannah Santos. Larissa Schmidt. Jean Shoesmith. Mark Thompson. From our PCA group, Vanessa Miranda Rosario. Luis Santos. Sean Sullivan.
And from our summer CNA class, we have Caitlin Borg. Mary Rose Boucher. Nora Addy. Maria Calmera. Catherine Gonzalez. Alyssa Love. Aline Montero. Sasha Rodriguez. And Carolee Rua. Folks, this is our summer and fall graduates in CNA, home health aide, and personal care attendants. I'd also like to have the students that spoke tonight stand up and applaud these students for coming forward to speak. They all did a fantastic job. During the semester, I warned them a couple of times that, you know, we're going to be looking for people to speak towards the end, and they're all the deer in headlights. Nobody makes eye contact with me. They all put their head down, and then by the end of the semester, we get a couple of, what?
I received no such warning.
By the end of the semester, I get some, oh, maybe I'll do it, and it takes a lot of encouragement and courage for them to get up here and do this. So thank you for participating in the program tonight. I'd also like to say a special thank you to our instructors, Judy, Suzanne, and Sue. These are probably the most dedicated CNA instructors that you'll find out there. They work crazy hours, multiple clinical days in a row to get the students through and to complete. They're always there for each other and for me. And they are just amazing, amazing people to work with. And I can't thank them enough for how much hard work they put into training the students to where they need to be to complete the program. To close the program, I just want to close with a couple of quotes. Before the quotes, once you join BCC, we always consider you part of our family, and we look forward to seeing you and your friends in our classroom and in the near future. Please speak of your experience here at BCC with friends and family. Education is a never-ending process. You have just begun to continue to strive to increase your education. Give yourself the leading edge in the healthcare field. I'd like to close the program with two quotes. The first is by Dr. Seuss. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know. You are the guy who'll decide where to go. The other one is, I hope your dreams take you to the corners of your smiles, to the highest of your hopes, to the windows of your opportunities, and to the most special places your heart has ever known. You are now the nuts and bolts of the healthcare field. You are the foundation to any success of any institution facility will have. Be proud to say, I am a graduate from BCC whenever anyone asks you what you do. Myself and the staff at the Center for Workforce and Community Education and Bristol Community College wish you success in all you do. Thank you all for coming, and thank you again to our amazing instructors and for all of the people behind me for their amazing support during this program. If we could have the graduates stand one more time. So a couple announcements. Somebody lost their glasses. In case this is anybody's up here, we have them. So come see us. We have cake and some snacks in the foyer over there that we'd like you to join. We'd also like to share an opportunity. If you know anybody, we'd love to have you share the word for us. We have a free training coming up for unemployed population. If you know of anybody at a free training for CNA, if you'd like any more information on it, please come see us at the end and we can give you a flyer. But we'd love to share that opportunity with anybody that you may know that could value from it. So again, congratulations to the students. I'm gonna ask them to stay on stage for just a quick second so we can grab some pictures, and then we'll have some cake and coffee out in the foyer. Thank you all for coming.